Oh my God. There's probably gonna be nobody here. Oops. My bad.
Self-defense, self-defense. It happens, you know?
Thank you. was satisfying. Thank you, sir.
Nope. Hey, what's going
Joey.
On, Julie?
How you doing?
How are you?
I'm great.
How are you making out today? Pretty good?
Why'd you get your gun out? Holy shit. Always got your gun out.
Yep.
What you got back here? Anything interesting?
You can get out of my office. Now.
I just want to see what's going on.
Get out of my office.
Oh, okay. It's not your office.
Randy, I don't think she wants you in there, bud.
You alright? You alright? I was just making sure.
What happened? What are you doing? What the fuck?
Man, I dare you to shoot. She fucked your car up, bud.
Jolie.
Yeah.
Is this your car?
Yeah.
Jesus, you're just loaded these days, huh? You just buy whatever car you want. How much does this thing cost you, huh?
$200,000.
Oh, jeez.
Nothing.
What you up to, huh?
Defending myself and my fucking property.
Yeah, was that what, Randy Bullitt?
Yeah.
What did his ass want?
To fucking harass me.
Yeah, fuck him. He's a little beta bitch anyways. Don't worry about him.
Yeah, pretty much.
So anything, interesting happened today, anything,
Well, I mean, I just got here in the city. 5 minutes later, of course, Mr. Bullitt's got to show up and start trying to start shit up. Man, leave and crash into my vehicle on their way out.
Of course, people always want to start shit. It's just how it is.
Yeah. More shit that's been going on forever. And quite frankly, I'm just getting tired of it. I'm over it.
You know, maybe he'll get over it.
Yeah, no.
Maybe one day. No, maybe he won't be a child about it.
He is a child. How's he gonna not be a child about it? He is a fucking child.
He belongs in daycare, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, pretty much. Pretty much. What can I do for you, Mr. Wong?
I don't know, I'm just chilling. I don't have any friends, so you're like my only friend.
Oh, that's nice.
I guess.
I'm happy to feel appreciated.
Of course. You're my dear friend I've known for a very long time. Why wouldn't I appreciate you?
Yeah. Listen, if he comes back here again, I'm gonna put a bullet in him.
Well, at least you at least make his name true, at least, you know?
Yeah. Just giving him his last name. This city is a fucking joke.
Oh, shit. Noodles in town again, huh?
Have you run into her?
No, I haven't yet. But boy, when I do, it's gonna be one funny moment. At least for
good?
Me. I mean, for me, I'll think it's hilarious, at least for me, I don't know.
are you gonna say anything?
Hell yeah, I'm gonna say shit.
Like what?
I'm gonna put my shit talking pants on, you know what I'm saying?
Listen, just be careful with what you say and how you say it.
Of course. You know me, Julie.
You might come across
as
a
person.
In a negative way.
Don't worry. Oh, well, you know, I sure as hope she's like in a positive way. I sure
as... Well, I mean, it might reflect on you negatively, though.
I mean, who cares at this point? What do I have left here in this town? What do I have left, Julie? Please tell me.
What? I mean...
I have a new home now. I have a new city.
Oh, where do you live now?
You know, Rivalry. A place, a beautiful city named Rivalry.
Yeah, I've been there before. I really didn't find a whole lot to do. Besides,
of course it's fucking Miller. Who do you think it is?
I'm a police.
Pull him over, pull him over.
Oh, nice.
Hi, Julie.
Alright.
That's that shit.
I'll be back in a jiffy.
Oh, okay.
I'll be back in a jiffy.
Where are you going? Are you really driving a taxi? Oh. Oh, hey.
Oh, hi, I didn't even see you there.
Oh, yeah, I'm just maintaining a state of hypervigilance.
Okay, I've seen someone run through here with blonde hair.
Oh, yeah, that was probably Eric. Is that you showing up in a cape?
Yeah.
Okay. Just chicken.
Did you change your pants?
I did. I don't know how I feel about them. Because they say stink on the ass, and I don't know if I want to be known as a stink ass. You know what I mean? What's so funny?
I need just to the change way you it. Said it, that's cool.
I need to change my pants, yeah. I think. I like that they're dark colored, but I don't know. What do you think?
I'm not really good at giving advice on fashion. I mean, I think they're okay, but depends if you want people to call you a stank ass. I mean, no, I wouldn't, but...
God damn it! Where are those people?
They seem to fit you okay.
Yeah. Are you saying I'm a stank ass?
What the f... No. Did you hear that?
Hear what? What was it?
I heard really loud gunshots.
Oh, sometimes it's the shooting range.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I just wanted to have a chat again. I went to the courthouse to ask for a weapons license, but obviously I got denied. I wasn't thinking when I went and asked. But apparently they said that the evaluation you did won't be any good or something.
Why not?
I have no idea.
Well, that's stupid.
I have to go on another note.
I want to know why. I'm a licensed qualified therapist.
Yeah, you'll have to go on. Well, don't throw it away, but go and talk to one of the judges, I guess.
They need one from the EMS department. Good luck with that, finding somebody in the city qualified.
Well, that's why I got it off you, because I knew that I probably wouldn't get it any other way, so. But anyway, I just wanted to ask, I didn't know how to deal with, I've seen Abby and Chris before, and it upsets me seeing them together. I didn't know how to deal with it, so I just sort of stayed away from them.
I mean, it's gonna be hard for a while. There is no right or wrong way, well, I guess there is definitely a wrong way to deal with it.
Like, I sent her a message saying, like, what do you see, what does he have that I don't? And she said it's just because she's EMS and he's EMS and she likes the medical background and they can spend time even when working together and stuff. And she said, does that help? And I said, oh, not really, but thanks anyway.
It's, you probably want to stay away from that. Stuff like that.
I mean, I'd like to be their friends, but when I see them together and they're and like drunk.
Oh, nothing. Hello. Everything
hello,
okay?
My friend
Leroy. James, just give
yeah,
James
just...
water.
What?
Huh.
Julie, this is my friend Luna. Luna, this is Julie. She owns the dealership.
Oh, there you go, James.
I think we met before, maybe.
That's for being so thirsty.
Hey, I have a question for you, Miss Luna. What do you think of these jeans I'm wearing? You think I should change them? It does say stank on the ass, and I don't really think I want to be
Leroy, follow me.
Being known as a stank ass.
Hold on, this is an important question.
you could change them to something similar, but without, like, a stank ass.
Hey, that's what I was thinking. I might try that.
Yeah. Don't want to accidentally give people the wrong idea.
Yeah. Yeah, I think you're right.
Don't
I think
you get spanked.
I think you're right. Aww. I'm gonna.
It was nice to meet you.
You as well. Yeah. You have a good day.
You too.
Yeah, like I was saying, Leroy thinks if I talk to a girl, I'm trying to get her. He doesn't understand that we can have friends.
But I mean, messaging her and asking questions like that, that's not really helping you know.
Yeah, I know. I don't know why I did it. I guess I was just, I don't know. It's just eating at me that, I don't know. I'm not sure. It's just, I need to try and just forget about it, I guess.
I know it's going to be difficult to do, but I mean, messaging her and stuff like that, that's not going to help you ever be friends. It's going to push her further away and make her feel uncomfortable, if I'm being honest. I don't really think that's what you intend to do or what you want to do.
No, it's just I don't, yeah. Like, oh, yeah, no, we'll still hang around and everything, but yet she's like, she's always with him, like, whether it's EMS or off duty, because they're both together, so.
Yeah.
But I guess I'm just going to have to try and forget about it, because if I keep thinking about it, it just makes me upset and angry.
Yeah. And I know that's going to be difficult. But I think right now, even trying to be her friend after saying stuff like that, in my personal opinion, I think it might be in your best interest to kind of avoid her for a little bit. And I know the city's not that big, so it's going to be difficult.
Mr. Eric, okay?
I don't know, where'd he go?
He put a car... Here.
Huh. Hi there, Eric.
Hey.
How you doing?
Oh, great. How about yourself?
I'm good. Do you guys mind doing me a favor? Maybe watching over this place, make sure it doesn't get exploded long enough for me to go change my pants.
Sure.
You want to come with me? Gotta go change my pants. Get off of my car.
Hey, I don't know if I met, but I'm James. Toll mechanic, nice to meet you.
Hey, nice to meet you. I'm Eric Wong.
I'll be right back.
What do you do around here? Okay.
I don't.
What are you doing? Hello?
Hello?
Oh.
What's going on? Hey, fuck you, Randy.
Holy shit.
Get the fuck out of my office.
Oh, god damn.
Randy, stop it right now, motherfucker.
Holy shit, I didn't mean that.
Bulletproof glass, bitches. I got your back, Julie, don't worry. I've got your back. Are you okay?
Yeah.
Alright, so let's make a report with the cops when they show up, yeah?
Please, get on the ground, do it now. Back to you. Do it, Gunpoint. Sit tight, don't think I'm moving a muscle. Sit.
Oh god, I won't stay down, I'm sorry, Morgan, I keep trying.
Davis, stay right there. Anyone inside the property, Miss Davis?
No, sir, they left.
Say, please, make yourself known.
Hey, Jenny!
Do I know you?
It's me, what? It's me, Eric. Eric Wong?
Yep.
It's so cold.
I'm Miss Davis.
Yes, ma'am?
Right, what's going on here?
So Randy and his pal showed up, alright? So they proceeded to go inside Miss Julie Davis's office. Seems like they're about to attempt to rob the place. He comes in, Julie and him get in a verbal altercation. He starts swinging at her and knocks her down on the ground. Then he swings around and swings at me. So I pulled my firearm out, and I tell him to leave. He did, and his friend starts shooting, and yeah. That's about the quick version of it.
Yes, sir, I believe they shot the local in that car.
Yeah, they shot that local, too.
So, Randy and who was it?
Curtis. I don't know who his friend is. Do you know who it is? Curtis, yes.
Curtis.
Oh, Mr. Swarrod, okay. What were they driving?
It looked like a T-20.
T-20? Yeah, a black T-20. They've been going around, in fact, earlier they, stopped my car and tased me out of it and then beat the shit out of my car.
Listen, I don't have a restraining order against Mr. Bullet.
Give me occupied times two. Curtis Swarroyd and also Randy Bullet. They just.
Yep, they tried to kill us both. They did try to kill us both.
So. Okay. Alright, let me, I'm restrained. Alright, so it looks like the games have started. We'll get a unit close to the vicinity of the area. If they come back, pop in a 911 call.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, they seem to have a thing going off, Miss Julie.
Reason, and you also have a firearms license for a reason, so if you need to use it, you can do. And we'll be just in the area, okay?
Yes, sir. I appreciate that.
Stay safe now.
Okay. But man, I sure hope they go to jail for a long ass time, you know what I'm saying? Jesus.
They won't.
They beat the shit out of my car. I don't even have enough money to fix that shit. All my cars are broken because I'm too fucking poor. Duh.
When did they beat the shit out of your car? Broken.
I don't know. I was just driving. He stops. And then they start beating the shit out of my car. And then they taste me out of it. And I'm like, I don't have enough money to fix this shit. That was my last not broken car. Jesus.
Yeah.
They're trying to get the working man down. So how you doing, huh? How you doing, girl?
Oh, fantastic. I'm wonderful. This is just so much fun when people come by.
How are you and, what's his name? Michael, how are you guys
My husband, we're okay.
I mean, I don't ever see you guys together.
Well, he comes in, like, in city usually later in the day. Usually not
aware. Yeah, but is he usually just on duty?
No. He wasn't on duty last time.
Oh, yeah, he goes off duty now?
From time to time. I guess it depends on how many officers are working and stuff. Like, he didn't work for a long time the other day, and then, you know, there were no officers in the city, so he had to go to work. Why are you staring into my soul?
Yeah, well, hey, I do it sometimes, you know what I'm saying? I just do it sometimes. I stare in people's souls. Oh, it's so cold. Ugh. You know, hey, psst.
Yeah, what? What is it?
Wow, what did the ad?
What?
I'm your friend, be nice. I'm your friend, be nice to
you.
Me.
What do you need?
Be nice. What did I ever do? Did you ever read that message I sent you on your phone, you know?
Oh, probably not.
Oh, motherfucker. Do it now, then. Do it now!
Wait, when did you send it?
Oh my god, it's on that Steam app on your phone, you know?
Oh.
Jesus.
On that one. My actual phone.
Yes, that one.
Yes, I read that.
I wanted to go out there and fucking, I don't know, do something, but then I, you know, my better judgment told me not to.
That's good. That's good. I'm glad to see you using your better judgment.
The funny thing is she was like, once she noticed it was me, she started using a fake voice. Like, trying to hide it so hard. I was like, really? Like, you could tell it was, like, the most fake voice ever, too. I'm like, really? Like, just, what the fuck are you doing? Stop being a little bitch and just man up. You know what I'm saying, Jolie? Why do all women in this town have to be bitches? I mean, not you. See, they should be like you, you know? Just fucking be like, you know, fuck it, you know?
I'm pretty sure there's plenty of people that say I was a bitch.
Yeah, no, but, like you don't bitch ass stuff. I'm saying, like, oh, if you see someone you don't like, you don't just sit there trying to hide your voice and, like, you know, run away when you notice it's dumb, right?
Well, I mean, I do that when Mr. Chang or his associates are around, but that's more so for my safety and my protection.
Okay. No, you get what I mean, Jesus, Julie. God damn.
Yeah. Yeah, I know what you mean.
God damn it. Why can't you just agree with me? Jesus.
Trying to avoid you, then she's trying to avoid you, though. You can't face her down and make her talk to you, though.
No, I can't, but... I sure as hell can kill her, right?
Well, I mean...
Unless I have more than enough reason to kill her, okay? I have more than enough reason.
Now, let me ask you this.
Yes.
Wait. Kill her or kill Luna? You know what I mean.
Wait, is that her? Is that what their person's name is?
So this is getting slightly weird for the city, if you know what I mean. I'm just saying you need to be careful because some of the things you may think about doing could be considered a harassment. And you may find yourself on a vacation.
No, I'm not going to do anything like that, Julie. Jesus, calm down.
And I mean, like, healing Luna, you know, for other reasons.
So that person's no longer noodle. They're now Luna?
Well, you know, I probably have multiple relatives in the city sometimes.
So is that like Noodle's relative?
I mean, it could be. I don't really know her that well. I just met her.
Nice.
My
nice.
Friend James told me her name and introduced me.
Nice, nice. My stomach hurts so bad, you're like, fuck.
Maybe you gotta poop.
Oh, I just did poop.
Thank you for sharing. I'm glad you spent so much time in my office.
Well, I mean, shit, you were suggesting something else. I'm telling you, I already did it.
Well, I'm going to the movies tonight. I'm gonna go see Jurassic World. Michael's taking me to the movies.
If I die, just tell my mama I love her.
Yeah.
Can you do that for me, Julie?
Why are you gonna die?
An extreme pooping accident.
Maybe you need my stank-ass jeans. But we're in my office. Might want to think about jumping. Listen, I'm just saying, you know, if you come across her.
Do you know where James is?
Why?
Because I want to borrow his jester.
I was here a little bit ago.
Oh, all right.
Can we try the mechanic shop?
Oh, yeah. There was a dentist there.
Oh.
Bye bye, Dune Muggy. Will it break your car?
No, it'll be fine. Hello?
What's up, Julie?
What? Is that Clarence? Who is that?
I swear to God, I might as well just have a name tag on my shirt saying my name. I'm so unwanted.
Felix.
Oh, it's Felix.
Grand Ole Climb Chilliad.
Oh, good luck with that. You can make it up Chilliad in a comment.
What'd you say, Justin?
Hop in, we're gonna go up Chilliad.
Nah, you're fucking crazy, I'm not getting in.
What do you mean?
This is ghetto, do you see this? How'd you buy this anyways?
I made it. I built it myself.
Yeah?
No, you didn't.
You gotta build it yourself.
Fake news.
It cost $20,000 for the engine and stuff. Alright, well, I'm gonna go try and find people who wanna come up out Chilead with me.
People, you better not find more than one, or otherwise they'll have a hard time riding along.
I can sit in the front. Look at it.
I cannot sit in here. The front.
Really, you can?
No.
Yeah.
Try it, Julie, get in.
Julie, get in.
I can't, Rip.
Look at it, I'll show you guys how you get in.
Yeah? How's that working out for you? Yeah, that...
You like this?
That looks exactly how I want to go up Chilead.
Alright, I'll see you guys later.
Yep.
Bye.
Why would you do that? Now he's gonna run instead of get in his car and drive away. God damn it.
And he literally been sitting there since I got here. I think he was stuck.
I don't think he was stuck. I think you made him scared and he ran away. What?
I'm calling the tow truck.
Oh, thank you. There's a couple of cars that need to be towed. This one, this, wait, probably this bike.
This one too, right?
This car right here and that one. Yep.
Is that your car inside?
Yep.
Whose bike is this?
Probably Justin's, but it can be towed.
Oh! I'm sorry. I tried to kick the car, but...
You gotta be a car kicking professional.
Julie, is this yours too? Is this one yours or...
Nope. Oh!
Oh, dodged it. Easy.
Oh, and you want me to hit you? Get over here!
No.
Ugh.
No.
Oh!
My glasses fell out, Julie. God damn it.
I'm sorry.
Rude.
Listen, that was really funny, though. I left their bike up the street. I got a bicycle. What I found? Found a bicycle.
How much are bikes?
This one I believe is 300. Anywhere from like 250 to 2900, I believe.
$2,900 for Jesus.
Hey, it's a fast bike. You could actually get a speeding ticket on that bike in the city. Goes
Did
faster
really?
Than yeah, it goes faster than 40 miles an hour.
That's wicked.
If somebody wanted to be an asshole, they could give you a speeding ticket.
Hi.
Oh, hey there, sir. What can I do for you?
I'm gonna buy a BMX bike. Yeah.
Oh, that's a good choice. That one's a lot of fun.
Yeah. Yeah. Gonna buy a BMX bike? Jeez, might kill yourself on that thing.
Why is he gonna kill himself on it?
Why would I kill myself? I don't know. Are you insinuating something?
I think he's insinuating that you might be too old to ride the bike. I don't think that's true, though.
Really?
You can never be too old.
That's terrible. I would never say that.
Felix, I might ask you not to say sorts of things like that, because,
I'm people a paying customer here. Huh?
Exactly, he's a paying customer, and I don't want to be accused of ageism.
Well, careful, sir. Right. Don't mess with the elderly, all right?
You want to have a bike race? Let's go.
I gotta go somewhere. I gotta meet an important client.
Oh, well, good luck.
Julie, I'm going to buy a bike. I'm going to buy a bike.
All right.
What the fuck?
What? Where'd you go?
I literally got in and my car's broken.
Oh. Sorry? Is everything okay?
It's Abby. Oh no, that's not Abby, that's Julie. Yeah, we got ran over.
Oh gosh, I'm sorry to hear that.
That's alright, James is dead, but I think he's okay.
No, he's not bad.
James?
Yeah, he was smushed under the truck.
Oh,
yeah, he's just a bit hurt. Maybe really hurt.
Where's James?
I will do that sort of thing.
It was Curtis.
Oh, I bet Randy was with him.
Yeah.
That's such a surprise.
Put all your dog somewhere. We gotta find
it. I don't know. He must be in the park somewhere. Were they in that Karuma?
Yeah, you hear him? Woof, woof. Yeah, black Karuma.
Oh. Good to know.
Doggy.
I'm gonna go get my car and pick up James from the hospital. I'll catch you guys later.
Bye-bye.
Twitch conversation.
Yeah, the handover process.
James, what happened?
Actually, nope, that was what I was talking about. When you started asking about fetishes, that was what I was referring to.
I was on top of a car, and Curtis ran into it, and the car landed on top of
it. That looks like Julie.
Are you okay? It is
Julie. Yeah, it sounds like Julie. Look at Julie.
It's amazing. Are you sure you're okay?
You're gonna go say hi.
I'm here to talk to a friend. I don't want to interrupt.
That's Oh god! James! Oh god!
James, did the trauma team take him into the netherworld?
Yeah! Oh god!
There goes James.
There he is!
He's okay.
Wait, where? Oh.
He's been released.
Magicians and wizards.
Wait, who is this?
Julie. You know me.
This is Joe. Everyone knows Joe Julie.
Oh, Joe Giovanni.
Bingo!
Uh-huh.
Oh god damn it. Right. Let me get a bus. I'll meet you there.
Go save all the left.
Oh, yep. I will see you later, Julie. Nice seeing you.
Unless it happens to be Curtis or Randy. They can die.
Hey, James, did you see me?
I don't know about that, but... Oh,
nice.
Maybe he's a zombie. So, apparently, the cops are after Curtis now because he was a potato.
Oh, good.
Oh, yeah.
What about Randy? Did I get him?
He was in the car with him, so I guess.
I don't know what they were just standing on your car and they were just like full on reversed into the car.
Yeah, there was like no reason to do it at all.
No.
Probably because they know you're my friend and they're fucking assholes.
Hey, it came out of nowhere.
Yeah.
Hi, lady. Where you going? She was in a hurry.
Holy shit, she's running fast.
Alright guys, well that's my cue to head out of the city for a while and rest up. I'll Hey Leroy, I can turn like you now.
Oh god.
When I got my back injury.
Oh sweet. Yeah, I'm not an ass.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, I'm not that fast. My reflexes are slow.
Yeah, let your arms be free.
And a one, and a two, and a three. Gotta have style about you. Move that body.
This ain't no, like, sexual workout song.
Hey, did you change your pants? Oh, you changed your pants.
I did. I didn't want to be known as stank ass, so I changed them. Why is that funny?
Some girls in the city don't even wear pants.
Luna keep... I just... The word stank ass just it makes me laugh, but Luna changed her clothes as well.
What, she did?
Yeah.
Yeah, you can't tell because he puts on the same clothes every
wait.
Time.
No, who, me?
I changed my clothes.
No, she was wearing a leather jacket before, I recall.
Yeah.
See?
Yeah, but she goes from leather jacket to the vest. To the leather jacket to the vest.
No.
All right.
That's not very nice.
Right, she should pick more clothes.
I can't afford that much clothes.
Oh, no. I'm sorry to hear that.
It's okay.
I mean, look at her jeans, they're all torn up. Must have had those for a long time.
Yeah, it had a whole bunch of rips in it.
Oh, this is great jeans. I love them.
I know, I love comfortable jeans. Those are my favorites. Like, well-worn in jeans.
I do too. I feel sorry for James.
What's going on? What do you feel sorry for me for?
What are you talking about, comfortable jeans?
These are comfortable?
Those cannot be comfortable.
Why not?
Because they're tighter than the woman's pants.
Are they?
Yeah, definitely.
Should I change them?
James, don't let people
tell you
what to do.
I'm not too into dressing male and female people. I don't dress people. I'm not into fashion.
You're not? That's a surprise considering how fashionable you look.
Yeah, Leroy.
Yeah, I just keep it slick, you know? Just put on a nice hoodie or a t-shirt, some shorts or some pants, and that's it.
Well, I'm gonna go think about some stuff, and I'll be around. You have a good night, and hopefully I'll see you later tonight.
Yeah, I'll be back in a couple of hours, and I'll come and say hello.
I gotta go think about some,
back home,
some movies tonight, but I'll be around later.
I'll come and say hello, or like what I say back home, I'll come and say good day.
Oh, okay. Get some rest.
Yeah, we'll do.
Good night, James.
I forgot Justin was even here.
I'll come and if you're still in the city, I'll come for a ride with you tomorrow in this thing.
I'll go around back.
Where'd you park, Luna?
Oh, behind there.
You fucking scuff lord! Get out of here, Justin!
I didn't do anything.
Get out of here!
I didn't do anything.
Get out of here! Actually, I need a ride.
After you beat up my car.
Yep.
Alright, where are you? The garage?
Yes, please. Actually, if you feel like driving around, you could drive me around for a couple minutes. I'll go let my dog and my head out.
Alright.
I gotta think about that real quick. It shouldn't take but a couple minutes.
Hello? Julie? Hello, Julie? Julie? Nothing happened.
What are you doing?
Well, I was climbing Mount Chiliad and, yeah.
I'm gonna guess it didn't go well.
No, it didn't. But we're still alive, it's fine. Oh god.
I would do me a favor. Will you go by the prison and ask, tell Randy Bullitt, you know, to enjoy his freedom?
Wait, do you want me to tweet it out?
Yeah.
Why, you don't have a phone?
No. Say something like, you don't look free to me.
Should I put Julie said?
Mm-mm.
Do you want to try and climb Chiliad again?
Why not?
Alright, I need to go get it fixed.
You know, Bubba, he got my comet to the top.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Using the way I did?
Oh, I wasn't looking at the way you did.
Anyway, I'll show you.
Huh. Oh, I like yours better. It's funny. I mean, that's also true. My friend Morgan robbed somebody for $300,000+ without a weapon. She just told him to put his hands up. He didn't have a gun or anything, and then just robbed him. It was pretty funny. I want to go to the hear the spooky stories. Can we go hear spooky stories?
Yeah, sure. Yeah, and you go back to the ATM. There goes Curtis. Holy shit! Hop out!
Oh!
No! I told you to hop out.
What happened? Oh god!
The car caught fire and I told you to hop out.
Oh! Where are we going? Call for an ambulance.
Hospital.
All them. Oh.
Don't worry, I called an ambulance.
Here's what you need to say. 78 years. Reckless of fading, non-functional.
Wait, what do I have to say?
Say that Randy paid you $50,000 to murder me. I'm just kidding.
Wait, so you want me to tell Randy I murdered you for $50,000?
Yup.
Why didn't you hop out?
I was thinking in my head about stuff. Then I heard you say hop out, and by the time I stopped thinking about stuff, it was too late. Also, as soon as I jumped out, I got hit by an oncoming truck. That didn't work out too well either way.
I'm gonna go with Tall Toe. Hear the EMS, they're coming.
Los Santos, oh goddamn it, Julie, what happened? Julie, can you hear me? Sir, do you know what happened to her?
Yeah. She got hit by oncoming traffic.
Oh shit, Julie. Alright, Julie, tell me where it hurts the most right now.
I feel nothing.
Oh, okay. So, did you lose consciousness when you got hit? Did you hit your head at all?
I got hit by a truck.
Yep, you lost consciousness probably. Alright, I'm gonna roll you onto a backboard, and I'm gonna put a C-collar around your neck, and then we're gonna talk, okay? So hold on. All right. Okay. Julie, can you? I'm putting my hand into yours. I want you.
Can I have an A collar? I've always been an above average student. I just got A's.
Well, I will see if we have any A collars in the hospital when we eventually get there. For now, all I got is C because I am a piss poor student. My apologies. So, I'm gonna put my hands into your hands. I want you to squeeze them tight, okay?
Okay.
Alright, give him a good squeeze.
Am I squeezing?
Squeezing. Okay, good grip strength. Good grip strength, alright. Now I want you to wiggle your toes for me. Let me see you wiggle them toes.
How you gonna see me wiggling my toes with my boots on?
Well, you could wiggle the front of the foot up and down.
I'm wiggling.
Okay, I see it. Good. All right, so your motor function's intact. You got good strength. Okay. Do you know what year it is?
Yes, I do.
Well, why don't you tell me?
2018.
Okay, what city were you in?
Los Santos?
You know, yep, there you go. Okay, good. A&O times 3. All right. I'm going to press on your belly, okay? I want you to tell me if you feel any pain when I do it. All right, I'm pressing. You feel any pain in your belly when I press?
Oh. Feels rigid, right? I got good, strong ab muscles. Feel those
yes,
abs.
Yes, you do, ma'am. Yes, you do.
That do a lot impressive. Of crunches.
Nope. I can tell. No pain, though, right?
Oh.
Alright. I'm going to loosen the straps on the backboard here, and I'm going to slide my hand underneath your back. I'm going to press along the middle of your spine. Tell me if you have any pain in the middle of your spine as I'm pressing, okay?
Ow! Poking me!
Okay. Oh, is it just the poke, or is that pain in your spine when I'm pressing?
I mean, there's a pain in my ass right over there, but other than that, I'm okay.
All right. I think you sustained a bit of a concussion, but that was probably about it. The rest of my exam is negative for any injuries, and you're neurologically intact. So I'm going to unstrap you from the backboard, and I'm going to take the seat collar off. I'm going to try to get you up on your feet, and we're going to see how you do, okay?
Okay.
All right, there we go. All that's off. All right, on the count of three, we're going to get up. If you experience any nausea, vertigo, or the world spinning, you let me know, and we're going to get back down and take care of it, okay?
Okay.
All right, 1, 2, and 3.
Ow!
Yep, you're a little floppy, but you'll get it in a second. There you go. All right, how do you feel?
Feel great.
All right. If you experience any neurological symptoms later on, come to the hospital to get checked out. You may have a little bit of nausea here and there. You may feel a little tired. That's okay, but anything past that, you're going to need to get checked out for a possible close-head injury, okay?
Okay.
All right, we got to stop meeting like this, Julie. Damn it.
I agree.
Okay. All right, you guys be safe.
Thanks.
No problem.
Have a good day, sir. Thank you for your service.
You guys have a great day. I'll be seeing you around.
Probably sooner than you think.
Oh, Julie.
Oh, God.
Got a car?
Yep. You're gonna beat it up, right?
Oh, I'm gonna get in it. I could use a ride. I wonder if my car's been scuffed at the hospital. Scuff Lord.
I'm not a Scuff Lord.
You're not? That's a surprise.
With James, he has been in town for a while.
Mm-hmm.
I just got in town.
why I look so mad when I'm riding in a car with somebody. I always look mad. I'm not wrong, am I?
No, you kind of look like serious and mad.
I see.
And it's scuffed.
God damn it!
What if I move it out of the scuffed area?
Maybe. Not to destroy it.
You want me to?
Yeah.
I'm just gonna ramp off of it.
No, it's not gonna move either. It's stuck. Which comedy club?
Is everyone leaving?
Me. Why would you say everyone's leaving?
Because there's a Kuruma that just passed us.
Bring your own friends. What does that mean?
What?
You said bring your own friends. You might not want to park in the back lot with you.
I'm parking up here.
Here
oh,
to
what's up, motherfuckers?
Hear a spooky okay. story. Ready.
I don't know if anyone else is coming. Y'all want to just start?
I mean, I don't have a spooky story to share, but I'll listen.
Yeah, I got a spooky story. Real scary one.
I need somebody to hold my hand if I get scared.
I can hold your hand. It's okay.
Oh, that's why you don't like change into women. Oh, that makes sense.
That's not... No. No. There's a special guy in my life. He just doesn't know he's special.
Oh, who's that?
Oh, you're stalking.
Oh, that'd be Leroy.
Oh my, I'm not, I'm just gonna stop stalking. What's stalking? Ah, jeez.
Who are you stalking?
She's
who
a
are you stalking? Tell me who you're stalking.
I'm not stalking. Oh god. Alright.
I might need to leave the city soon and take a freaking nap.
Yeah, I'll try to make the story quick. We'll wait a few minutes, see if anyone else show up.
Take your time. Oh, I came to see and talk to a judge. But it's not working. There's never a judge.
Yeah, the judges are assholes too.
Yeah.
You're telling me shit.
They told me to wait 4 more days because I have a bunch of speeding tickets to get expunged.
Fuck expungement. I'm tired of paying for that shit. The police
they told
are just
me
gonna.
I need a gun license because I cussed.
What are we doing now?
Oh, police are here.
Everybody assume the position.
I don't know, I thought someone was getting arrested here.
So you came over to check out the scene. Why don't you go ahead and leave the area, sir?
Guys, let's go tell some stories.
Oh, I'm ready.
Those doors are scary as hell.
Was that your story?
No, that ain't a story. That's a real story. Based on true events.
So that's why the police are here. They want people to admit to stuff that they've done.
Alright, let me see if I can get this microphone. Oh, there we go. She gonna miss the story!
Got trouble.
Alright, I'm telling a story anyways. Alright guys, so who here in the city knows a girl by the name of Honey King?
Oh, I know Honey.
Alright, well this story is based on true events. So, Honey King lost her job, and she became a stripper. And then she became, you know, one of my best friends. Well, she was always my best friend. But then she went down a dark path. So one day I wake up inside of a house. I don't know how I got there. I don't know nothing. And I go around the house, and I just hear a lady crying. And I turn around the corner and I see Honey. Then what's wrong, Honey? What's wrong? And she jumped on top of me and started beating me down. She turned into a monster.
Oh,
and
gosh.
For 3 or 4 hours, I was stuck inside of this house with just me and Honey and a whole bunch of baby dolls for some reason. And she just kept attacking me every time I seen her. Then the next day, I wake up, I'm not in the house anymore. And we go around to this place with James and Roland, and we get attacked by a ghost. I think it was Honey. She became possessed, beat me up while she was still in her human form, then she turned into a ghost and attacked everybody. And now she's haunting the city, which is why all the cars are scuffed.
Oh, that makes sense.
See, told you it wasn't me.
Yep, that's the whole story.
I saw a ghost in the city once.
Oh, you gotta get on the stage.
Okay. I don't have a
fancy
microphone.
It's the microphone up there. I didn't do nothing special.
Okay, so this was like a week or two ago, okay? I was in the city. I just got off the train. And I was just walking to the garage at Placeville Street to get a car and I start being hit, but nobody's there.
Oh shit.
And I get hit again and nobody's there. And I'm like, what the fuck? Who's hitting me? And I get tripped. And then I'm in the middle of the road at this point and I'm fighting this ghost for my life. I'm swinging at nothing. I have no idea where he is. If I could even touch him. Okay? And I'm like, fuck it. I must be crazy. Maybe I've been drinking again. I don't know. But then I go to go to the garage some more. And I'm crossing the street and I get beat to the ground.
Damn, this sun has turned dark.
And then the spirit, he lifts me up and takes me on a bicycle. But I don't see anything. All I see is a bicycle. It's a ghost carrying me along on a bicycle. And eventually we end up at Pillbox Hospital and it crashes. And then the medics are like, what happened, Julie? And I'm like, it's a ghost, but they don't believe me. Until the ghost starts attacking one of them. And everybody's like, who hit him? And I was like, I told you it was the ghost. But then I just run away. Yeah. And then I go to Legion Square Garage on the county. It's closer. I'm trying to get a car. And I pull out my FMJ. And I'm getting ready to go. And I see Gremlin Hot Dogs, and I'm like, well, I'm going to talk to Gremlin for a minute. So I talk to Gremlin, and then the windows shatter in my car. But nobody's around.
Shit.
And Gremlin's like, what the fuck happened to your car? And I was like, it's a ghost. And then I'm standing there talking to her, and I'm about as far as I am away from the microphone, and all of a sudden she gets knocked into her motorcycle, knocked on the ground, tripped up. And she's like, why would you do that to me, Julie? And I was like, I didn't do it. It was the ghost. And then at that time, I was standing by my car, and I get hit into my car, and the door falls off. And it was a ghost. And then the district attorney shows up and sees me tripping over stuff on account of the ghost beating me up and stuff. And he's like, what's wrong with you, Julie? Why would you break your car? I was like, it's a ghost. And nobody believed me. But there really was a ghost, and it destroyed my car. And the ghost owes me about $60,000, but I ain't been able to find him. He's not messed with me since that day.
That's horrible.
Yeah.
How long ago was this?
It was like a week and a half ago.
Man, that's right when Honey started having her issues.
Why is it so foggy in here?
Because it's spooky.
Because it's scary story time.
My ghost story.
You gotta have some scary stories.
You got any scary stories, Justin?
No.
Justin, you're boring. Wake up, Luna. You gotta tell a spooky story.
Yeah, we need spooky stories.
A lot of stories already. I only had one. Yeah, there you go. Your turn, Luna. Spooky story.
Right. I'm just gonna be brutally honest. I have my friend trouble in my head right now. I'm trying to fix stuff.
That can be spooky.
Yeah, that's kind of spooky.
Too bad he wasn't thirsty like James.
Huh.
Well, yeah, he's actually from the city. It's kind of... Yep.
Tell him, bring his ass here and tell a spooky story. We got shit to do. Justin, it's your turn. Spooky story.
I don't have any spooky stories.
Yeah, you tell me that one time you wanted to be a female.
What? Never wanted to be a female?
Yeah, you did.
No.
Remember you was going to the clothes store, you're dressing like a woman. You're like, man, I think this would be awesome. That's why you never wear a shirt.
What do you mean? I'm wearing a shirt right now.
Yeah, because you're trying to blend in.
Oh, my goodness. The man says he ain't got a spooky story. It's probably for the best. He'll make up something and it'll be shit.
I'm gonna find something spooky. Something.
Yeah. Well, we don't got all day. Julie's sleepy.
Huh?
I don't know, I should probably try and stay awake. But then I'm going to the movies and I don't want to fall asleep in the movies.
What movie are you going to see?
We're going to go see Jurassic World.
Oh, shit, with dinosaurs and shit.
Yeah, I'm going to see dinosaurs.
You know, I actually killed a dinosaur once. I'll tell you the story. Luna, you was there with me. This could be your scary story.
Wait, when? What? What's
that? That big-ass pink dinosaur was a donut.
I believe he has a hot dog. Doesn't he have a hot dog?
Yeah, that's it! Yeah, that's the guy!
We started
shooting. Go tell him! You gotta get on the stage! You gotta get on the stage!
I don't remember at all. My brain doesn't work, really. So like, we were driving in a stolen car.
Oh, gosh.
We saw a pink dinosaur. It was gonna attack us. Oh, God. So like, we took our guns out and started shooting it. Didn't die.
I mean, ain't you seen Jurassic Park? Guns don't work against dinosaurs. They got too much scaly skin.
That was scary. Yep.
Tell them how we hit it with the car.
Uh-huh.
Oh, yeah. And I went, like, full speed forward into it.
Oh.
It was like it was made of rocks or something. The car broke.
Yeah, they're pretty strong and powerful beasts.
Yeah. Yeah, they are.
That's pretty scary.
A microphone's always this shiny.
I don't know.
Sometimes it depends on how cheap they go.
Alright.
Oh, God. Kyle Pratt is on duty. Oh, no. I'm going to jail.
He's the worst cop ever.
He is. He's pretty bad. He's worse than Penis Popper.
Whoa, who is Penis Popper?
He's the bald guy who looks like a dickhead. His head is literally shaped like a penis.
I don't think I've ever seen him.
His name is Plain Copper or something.
Yeah.
Oh, shit, yeah, the guy that looks like Chemo.
Yeah, that son of a bitch.
Yeah, I call him Cooper.
I call him Penis Popper.
I have to remember that. I tried to explain to him how to grow some hair, and he wouldn't listen.
How do you grow some hair?
I guess I can tell a story for this. It's a story. So one day after, hold on, I like to use the switch. There we go, there's a switch on here. So one day, I had gotten hurt real bad, and I could no longer feel my leg, because I went to tackle a ghost off a mountain, and I broke my leg.
Oh,
true
God.
Story, it was a ghost on the mountain.
Yeah, I've seen
so
that.
So I broke my leg, it hurt so bad, but I didn't have feeling in it. And I kept telling the doctors, and then, Mayor Lisa decided she needed to plant me into the ground and regrow me as a new person so that I could walk again. So after her and Kai did the hole for like 10 minutes, they planted me and watered me until I grew up into a full-size Leroy tree. And that's what I told that police officer. I said, if you want to grow some new hair, we got to plant you in the ground and regrow you.
Oh.
Yep, that's the story.
It's pretty good. That makes sense, I guess.
Yeah, it was nice being planted, and it planted me right in front of Pillbox.
Oh. It'll be like beside Pillbox. There's like concrete in front of Pillbox.
Does that mean you're married to Mother Nature?
Get married.
So Mother Nature's your mom?
No, I don't. My mom's a crackhead.
Mom's a crackhead?
Alright, guys. Yeah, mom's a crackhead, dad's a crackhead, I was a crackhead. I'm better now. I'm going outside.
Okay. That was a good, scary, spooky stories time. I wish more people would have showed up.
Yeah. Wonder if I'm the one that's scared. I've been thinking about this, if I should, like, leave the city and come back again.
Well, the train ride, I don't think it's too long, but...
I don't know.
Still a... I guess I should go. I'll see if my car's unscuffed. That ghost is...
Nah, it's probably scuffed forever.
No, don't you say that. I love that car. I just bought it.
But everything's
scuffed forever.
I bought a shitlord jester. Ow, this candle is burning my feet.
She gets herself assault in RS. No one drives those in the city.
Yeah.
How do you get out?
Alright guys, let's go outside! It's too foggy!
It is, I'm scared. I don't know how to get out. Hello? Oh.
I don't believe it.
So, how do we get out of here?
Alright, you guys can take a ride with me if you guys want.
Oh, he got dressed!
Yeah, we parked up the street, so if a lot of people came, we wouldn't get scuffed.
Well, if one of us is scuffed.
And we're not scuffed! I don't know. Ma'am, I love your rainbow tights! Those are cute. They look like a lot of fun. Oh, I did not expect that. Don't jump over that wall.
Oh.
Oh, no.
I told you.
Unlock the door. Unlock the doors.
I guess to Texas?
Yeah, it's unlocked.
Oh, it's still locked. Unlock it.
Yeah, unlock the doors.
I'm unlocking.
Okay.
Okay, let me try this.
Shit, it's scuffed.
Give me the keys.
Yeah, try it. Don't follow me. Vehicle not found.
I need a ride!
It's an Uber that has only two seats. We're gonna have to beat it up.
So, I kinda ordered a taxi, but I feel like we need more than one.
I'll call for a taxi as well.
Alright.
Taxi!
If it's an Uber that only has two seats, we're gonna have to start beating it up.
Horrible.
Watch it, okay? Whatever.
I've heard mixed things about driving an Uber.
Yeah, apparently it can get you deported.
Yeah.
So I was doing Uber with a motorcycle and,
Oh, well, a motorcycle doesn't make fucking sense, but if you got a four-door car, I don't see why you can't be an Uber.
Yeah, I've always liked four-door car Ubers. As long as you're not in a damn two-seater with all your friends, I'm I'm happy.
Yeah. And also, people running a cash cab, I don't know about that either. I actually got fussed at because I was lucky golden cab because I was bored and I was offering free lottery tickets for people who took a ride in my lucky golden cab. And they were like, like if you were cheating in a video game or something, like exploiting something,
crazy.
You know, that's what the gods kind of indicated to me. So I parked the cab and I went back to my dealership to sell my lottery tickets, and I got a vacation to the Banhammers for disrespect for some reason.
Damn, that's crazy. You seem so nice.
Yeah, I know. That's pretty dumb. So I don't know how a cash cab is different than a lucky golden cab.
No, it all sounds the same.
Who's that? Hello? The fuck?
Stupid Uber with two seats. I have to beat it up.
There really only two seats in there?
That's a taxi, people.
Yep, only two seats in that shitty car.
How many chairs are in here?
I only got one, sorry.
Oh, god damn it.
Oh, shit.
Oh, shit.
How can I have a fucking cab with one seat?
Fuck you.
Quick, beat it up.
That's the stupidest shit I ever heard of. I'm glad he came and collected the fucking money. That was real good. I'm gonna call for another cab. I swear to fucking god, if he comes back, I'm gonna put a bullet in his fucking head.
I thought he was gonna pick up all of us in just a two-seater. Man. Yeah, but your car is gone and the other one's scuffed and everything.
No, the other one is in there.
This is stupid.
Anyone have locks?
I used to have packs.
I don't carry lockpicks on the account. I don't want to go to jail for stealing a car.
Oh, well, I'm going to run to the store then. Just tweet at me if anything happens, alright?
That's fucking bullshit is what that is. That shouldn't be allowed.
Well, she's going to be running for a while.
She's got her own issues.
It's fucking taxis.
And, what's it called? Sexual Tourette syndrome? Her and Honey King got it.
Oh. Where are the fucking taxis in this goddamn city?
Shit, I'm gonna be stranded here forever. This ain't good. It's getting too dark.
Well, we could just go south to Dorset. There's a garage there. We could go west to the golf course and get a golf cart. One of those options sounds the best.
Luna, where'd you go?
She ran to the storm.
I don't think I have luck. No, I don't have any luck.
I'm gonna go check up the cars on Scuff.
That shit ain't unscuffed.
You do and you don't. It depends. I don't know. This is the reason, though, why I think you should be in a taxi cab. So you don't drive around a fucking two-door car.
Oh, damn, I had another scary story. I just remembered.
Oh, what was it? We got time. I don't think any taxi cabs. I got a scary story. One time I was standing on a street corner because my ride was scuffed by the ghost, and a fucking idiot in a two-door taxi cab came by. Collected the money and left.
Damn, that's horrible. So my scary story, me, Ivan, Jesus, and Jocelyn. Yep, we were going into Jocelyn's new house. Me, Ivan, and Jocelyn made it upstairs through the elevator. Jesus never made it up. So we went and looked for Jesus. We found him outside getting slammed into the post. There was like a wall. And he just kept getting slammed into it and slammed into it and slammed into it. And he was screaming for help and we couldn't help him. It was like Freddy Krueger had him in his sleep.
Oh, that's pretty scary.
Yeah, he was dying and he couldn't control it. He just kept getting picked up and slammed into the wall. It was horrible.
Yeah, they have. Yeah. Like, if it's a four-door, like, vehicle, like Matt Ubers in his eco-friendly search, which I think is okay. It's got an RP reason behind it.
Man, that really sucks. I parked all the way over here just so my car wouldn't scuff.
And then it scuffed.
Maybe if you would have told a scary story, your car would have scuffed.
That's true.
What the ghosts do, the ghosts hate a whole bunch of dull people just standing around.
I don't think ghosts you necessarily have to. I've never heard a definitive answer, but I mean, driving a fucking two-seater as a taxi is just stupid.
Yeah, because they get bored.
You don't drive them to drive a fucking Granger, drive a limo. They actually wouldn't let Jackson Wilson drive his limo anymore as a taxi, which I think is dumb.
Oh, you see that?
See what?
I see what?
Power Rangers.
Oh, they the Power Rangers? You had on a baby mask.
I'm gonna bait the shit out of you. Talking about Power Rangers.
You already did.
And then we're gonna have a ride.
He was just like the Power Rangers the other day. He was just wearing light up clothes with a baby hat. That's not a Power Ranger.
You're right. It's the Laser Force.
Yeah, Power Rangers is better. They go around beating up people and robbing them.
Cool. Where's this fucking taxi cab?
I don't know, it always confused me. You see like 100 taxis, and as soon as you call one, there's no taxis. What are you fucking doing?
I think they all wait till one taxi picks them up, and then they just go along after and take the money.
So fresher.
What if Luna got attacked by a ghost on the way to the store?
Hey guys,
I'm here for the taxi call.
Yeah, what about the local in your car?
You got a person in your car!
Yeah, you guys can get in. Kick the, you know?
But there's three of us!
I can't get...
Julie, you hopping in?
Nope.
Are you sure?
Yep.
I mean, I took the fare. I feel bad. I don't want this now. What do you want me to do? What?
I couldn't get in that taxi cab. I got a restraining order. I couldn't get in that cab. I got a restraining order against him.
Oh shit, is he a criminal?
No, no, he's an upstanding citizen of the law. Ugh, fucking Rammy.
What did he do? He's trying to flirt with you too much, like James would?
We went in. You know, while I was at a karaoke contest, he went and poured gasoline on my vehicle and blew it up.
Damn, that's horrible. People are just evil. That looked like the guy that blew up Elena's car yesterday.
Oh, there's Felix. We can get a ride with Felix.
Hop in.
Oh, okay.
I'm gonna ride with Felix.
God damn it, I'll just leave my car.
Oh, wait! On. Okay, I'm going with Felix. Who's Felix?
Thanks.
Hello?
Hi.
What's up, motherfucker?
You know some fucking asshole came by collecting taxi fares with a fucking two-seater car? That's some stupid-ass shit.
Yeah, that's pretty dumb. You just want to go to the garage or what?
Yeah, that'll be fine. Thank you so much.
Oh, shit, I thought you was gonna lose it.
I mean, my choice of taxi was a two-seater or a Rammy. And I chose neither.
Is Justin yelling out the car at us?
I think so, yeah.
Like no one's here. Yo, Justin, I can't hear you through the fucking car!
Ow!
What the hell?
Oh, ow! Shit, we crashed into a ghost! There's more ghosts, I told you!
Yeah.
Yeah, that's definitely a ghost.
Thank you, Felix.
Yep,
thanks for the ride!
Nice.
Holy shit, I knew there was ghosts!
Aren't we all gonna drive around?
We don't know where Luna is. We lost her. You gotta find her.
We lost her. I gotta go get my car fixed up.
Go find Luna. You can do it.
Yo, what's up?
Hey, yeah. I don't know why you be yelling through windows and stuff.
How you doing?
Your voice got hurt after that. You was yelling so damn loud.
Hey, Julie?
Hello?
Hello? Is this Julie?
Yeah.
Hello? Is this Julie?
What can I do for you?
Who the fuck's that?
Alright.
It's just Julie.
So listen.
Right.
I have $25 in my pockets, right? I bought this bike for $17,000 and now I'm in minus $20,000 debt.
What bike is that? That the Gachu?
I think so, yeah.
You know, somebody did that the other day. Oh, well, they ended up in like $400,000 in debt. That, if I'm being honest, I don't have anything to do with that. You're going to have to talk to the, you know, gods of the city.
Alright, I will do that. Because, you know, I don't want, people getting pissed off with you thinking they're being ripped off, you know?
Yeah. I mean, the price that's listed is the price it should be, but I mean, you're not the first person that's actually come to me with that, if I'm being honest.
Alright, yeah, I mean, it's only like $20,000, but that's not the plan, right?
Yeah, I got fucked over a lot more than $20,000. I think it's to a tune about $400,000 or $200,000.
Oh, damn. Alright then. Thanks.
It's negative dollars in your pocket. Right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know why it does
negative
that.
$20,000. Alright. I'm gonna go to the eye doctor and see if that makes a difference.
Alright, let me know
hey,
if
Julie.
It does.
Alright.
Yeah.
Can I get a ride to the eye doctor?
Yeah. Maybe, I don't know, the tires might be bad. Tires might go out.
How fast does this car go?
I don't know, I've never taken as fast as it could go. The mechanic costs $60,000 to repair and I'm not the best driver.
Thank you.
Yeah, no problem. Stop by pillbox and get my car stuff. Not. I need to find out how badly damaged this is. Sounds just fine. The eye doctor. 64%. I could. Some assistance. I'll just go back and sell some lottery tickets. Shoot Randy again. On my way. Let's go, let's go. Remember, go. Get those keys.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yes, I did.
It's down to about 64%, but it costs $26,000 to repair, so.
Oof.
Yeah. Yeah, he's pretty much the world's worst criminal. Wait around for my cart. I'm gonna have to leave soon. Oh, it's only 3. In a little bit, going to the movies. Everything okay?
Everything back to 100?
Yeah, I was just asking if you wanted me to make everything 100%.
As long as it's 80-90%, that'll be okay.
Okay, I was just wanting to make sure.
Yeah, thank you. I'm gonna eat all the popcorn at the movies and the sandwich again. $500 might be less than that. At least I confirmed that my glass at the dealership is bulletproof. That's good. The cops respond to the shots, yes. They responded by having me and Eric get on our knees with our hands up. Staining us. They actually never took a statement from me. Taking so long. It's about the response I expected. It's gonna cost me. I'm gonna spike with them. How much?
Your bill is $3,000 to 263.
I gotta run to the ATM. I only got like 2,400 in my pocket. Be right back.
Okay.
$3,000. Good lord. What account? 263? 263. There you go.
Thank you very much.
No problem. Thank you. I appreciate it. You have a good day, sir.
Too.
Generally how the police respond, though. They just go detaining everybody. Read you your rights. GSR test. They actually didn't GSR test. Works in my favor.
Thank you.
go and find. Look, do you want to stay with us, or do you want to? Cause, you know, all we're going to be doing is going smoochy smoochy. You know, do you want to stay?
Yeah,
with
I
us?
Don't
want to
see that.
Cousin?
All right, see you later. Bye.
Bye.
Who doesn't want to say smoochy smoochy? I'll watch. Shit.
How do you feel about that, Chris?
I cannot do anything right today, damn it.
What do you mean? Smoochy smoochy is always right. What are you talking about? Let's see it. Hold on.
Right. What? No, Julie, not getting it out now.
What? Getting what out? What do you mean? I was just saying smoochy smoochy. What? Good. Oh my God. What did you? Wow.
Nasty.
Wow.
Abby.
What?
Yeah. He needs help pulling it out.
Oh,
this is horrible. I can't look.
Oh my God. This is terrible. This is not appropriate. This is in public. This is in public in front of a police station. What?
Yeah, exactly.
What are you doing?
No wonder James is upset. Abby don't like him because she's a freak.
What?
That's not
what?
Very nice.
Oh.
That is nice to say. People love freaks.
No, I think
Chris,
he's meaning you're
like
a freaky
Abby.
In the sheets.
Yeah, exactly. Like you could help him pull it out in the middle of the police station in the daytime.
It's when I see
it. I don't think that's what he meant. It's been a really long day for him. Give him a break.
It's been a long day for you? What happened? You have to pick up too many people that got exploded by cars?
Julie, you know what it's like when you literally have calls stack one after another, hour after hour, including people dying and all the paperwork, and literally you don't get a chance to even have a single sip of coffee. It's been one of those days today. I know that you would understand that.
I do, but look at the alternative. Think about when it's quiet and there ain't no calls and you're stuck doing nothing.
Mm-hmm.
Trying to figure
I know,
stuff
but,
out.
Hello. And then on top of that, I've also been, I introduced, you know, Abby to Neve. So, and Abby and I were a bit nervous as to whether Neve was going to like the fact that her dad's got a girlfriend now. And so,
So how did that go?
You're such a baby, by the way. It actually went really well.
Weren't you tweeting that she was going to murder you?
No, that's Poppy, my niece.
Well, why is she going to murder you?
Because she sassed me and I sassed her back and won.
Oh.
She didn't like being out-sassed by an old man and she's a teenager. See?
Listen. I'm gonna say something now, and don't be upset, okay?
Why can't I be upset?
Because it's just an observation, okay? It's an observation, and
okay.
Why are you wearing a leather cuff on your arm?
We've been talking about his outfits this whole time. He dresses like a school kid.
I mean, he's wearing like the sports, you know, jersey that makes him look like a jock, but he's wearing like the golf leather bracelet.
Kai. Do you still carry a gun? Do you still carry a gun?
What's going
on? I'm
on
duty right now, so I can't answer that, but
Okay, put a bullet in my head. Right now, straight into my eyeballs, blow my brains out back of my head. Right
hi,
now,
Amber.
Please.
What the hell went what have you done?
Hi.
Come on, Kai. Yeah.
Okay,
please.
This does not look
just
appropriate.
Do it.
What?
Right now.
Oh my
right
god.
Right now.
This...
I don't. Is this why I
stop.
Came to Mission 04?
What the hell? No.
What
there's
is...
a situation. I mean.
I'll be back in a minute.
I can hit you with a wrench.
Yep, that would help. Very helpful.
This. No, Leroy, put your wrench down.
I'm still waiting for the smoochy smoochies.
I just came back to let you know that you're fucked.
Thanks, Neve.
You're welcome.
That sounds ominous. I mean, I don't think you yet, but I mean, it wasn't
did
for
I
lack
give
of
you
trying.
Keys to the car, Abby?
But what?
Yeah.
What is going on, Chris? I gotta
What's
go with them, and then we'll be back. Hey, Leroy. What's up, motherfucker?
I'm gonna go.
What's up, motherfucker?
Jump it.
Right.
Oh my God.
Abby.
I don't know
Abby,
what's going on.
We need to go and strategize. If you have any feelings for me whatsoever, we need to strategize so you actually have a live boyfriend at the end of the day, rather than, you know, like a, just a corpse on the floor.
What happened?
Abby, you've gone quiet. I don't like when women go quiet. That scares me.
How murderous are we talking here?
Really bad.
Really murderous.
Like really murderous. Like, beat the crap out of cops murderous.
What's this person's name?
Poppy.
Oh. Oh, yeah.
See? Every time I say the name, everyone's like, oh, yeah, you're fucked.
Well, no, I didn't say you're fucked. I mean, yeah, but quite violent.
Good luck to you. It was nice knowing you.
Abby, please, please,
Julie,
Abby,
that is not
please
very
stop.
Nice.
Well, I mean, in all likelihood, I'm gonna die.
We're all gonna die someday. It's just a matter of when.
Come on. Let's get in the car.
Catch you guys later.
Maybe get
Abby.
Rid of your leather bracelet.
It'll turn up to Julie.
I
like my leather bracelet.
Okay.
It'll be fine. Don't worry. He'll make a beautiful corpse.
Yeah, we'll be able to identify him by his leather bracelet.
I'm not a necrophiliac, so...
You don't have to be a necrophiliac. There's plenty of thirsty gentlemen in the city.
It's true, too.
Dang.
He's gonna be fine.
British accent.
Narrows it down slightly. I'm certain they'll be back. See if I got paid. I'll give it a couple of minutes. I went to bed at 7 o'clock this morning and got up at like 11. Yeah. I could use a nap. Oh, they do that. I don't know. I don't like to mess with the locals when they do that, though, because then they leave their cars here. Take a, like a walk around the block and come in and get in the car. If you leave them alone. Land, leave them alone. I think Eric's car. Somebody must not have seen.
Okay, Miss Davis.
Oh, yes, sir. It was, I thought that car was scuffed on the can of how it was parked. Thought somebody may have, not seen it and smashed into it. I did call for a tow truck, though.
This blue one here?
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't think tows are on, unfortunately.
I didn't want to call.
you want it gone, Miss Davis?
Yes, please. It's taking up, like, a handicapped parking spot in a regular spot, so.
There you go.
Thank you, sir. Much appreciated.
No problem. You stay safe.
You too.
Sorry, 6 10 60.
Hey, they replaced my door pretty quickly. Oh. I thought about sleeping in that lane. I was trying to find a judge in the city. There's never a judge in the city. No idea what that could. I think I'm gonna go take a nap and get up the movies and be back in a couple of hours. My lottery drawn tonight. Probably gonna be an unbelievably long train. Felix? I know, Felix. Aw, thanks, man. I'll let you know how the movie was. I'm hoping it's good. It looked good, so we'll see. I'm out. I'll be back. I'm out. Nap time. Thanks for hanging out. Much appreciated. Can't play my goodnight song because I keep flagging me on YouTube for copyright material. Also, it's not nighttime. But anyways, I'll be back. Oh, I'm going to see Jurassic World, the new one. Anyways, I'll be back.